the film. The one thing that we decided very early on was we were not going to see anybody strip, in fact, because I wasn't particularly interested in that. And to be honest, the first couple of drafts of the script ended without the strip. They ended with us moving outside of the hall, the working men's club where the strip takes place, and witnessing the reality of the world as it still is. And it was David Orkin at Film 4 that said, you cannot keep an audience waiting for a strip for 90 minutes and then not give them the strip at the end. And it was him, and rightly so, who overruled me effectively and said, you have to do that. Then unfortunately he wasn't able to finance the movie, but nonetheless, it was his contribution that definitely said, you have to get them to strip at the end. And the other obviously important thing was to get a group of people who were not obviously handsome, were not obviously attractive, were not obviously the kind of people who do this job normally. That was fundamental to the central idea, but also to the fact that the film comes from a real world, and the real builder, a real steel worker, unemployed steel worker, etc., etc., does not necessarily have a Chippendales body. Funny enough, one of the things that happened while we were developing the project, while we were just about to start filming, was we got a note from a production company, Andy Harris's production company, was saying, wait a minute, you're doing a movie that I've already done, that I am making. And I said, I don't know what you're making. And he had, in fact, made a film for, I think, ITV. I can't remember if it was ITV or the BBC. I suspect it was ITV because his relationships were with Granada. And that was a group of unemployed, actually minors, who stripped. And the interesting thing there that was, well, first of all, the issue disappeared immediately when it turned out that we had started developing our project long before he had started developing his, so he didn't pursue the story. But the first 5 minutes of his film was a group of very handsome, athletic, attractive steel miners taking their clothes off. By the seventh minute of his movie, they were head stripped. So the movie had nowhere to go. Plus, the subjects were not real. And we did exactly the opposite. We made sure that the people were as real as possible and obviously didn't take their clothes off until as late as possible.
You've been listening to a Highbrow production.